Hi guys, Matt Thurtell here from Endtrack. With the addition of our loop browser, we're working with producers to create new sound packs for you. In this video, we're going to walk through the process of building a loop into a song using the Eclectic Essentials pack by Kato on the track. We've had a few requests for this. In this part, we'll start work on a track which could, for example, be sent to a vocalist, a rapper, or be exported and released as a beat online. Let's start by opening up Eclectic Essentials. This pack is a mixture of fresh loops, one-shots, and instruments. It's going to spark a lot of ideas for your productions. We'll open the loop browser by clicking the Use Loops icon from the launch screen. We can also access it via the loop browser icon here. Once we're inside the loop browser, we'll select Add-ons, where we can see all of the available sound packs. We want to search for Eclectic Essentials. If you haven't already downloaded the Eclectic Essentials pack, it's easy to do. Click on the pack name, which will be in grey, and we can see that the add-on manager automatically appears, which gives us the option to download the pack. Once we click Get, the pack downloads and is ready to use. So, let's go through some of the loops that we selected with the producer Kato on the track and his team. They're seriously good. I love this wonky keys loop called Analog Tape Keys. It's 149 BPM, but let's make it a touch slower for the arrangement we're going to write. So, let's go to the metronome and select 130 BPM. And we'll change the song key to G as well, using the drop-down. So we'll select G. We'll import the loop by clicking and dragging on the plus button. Endtrack will automatically match the loop tempo to that of the project. We'll also pitch shift the audio file down a semitone to the song key of G, using the pitch shift drop-down included directly on Endtrack loops. We like to change the loops in their original form slightly, so we can make them more of our own. This is especially important for this loop because it's going to form a central part of this track. We've changed the tempo and pitch of the loop. Our last step here is to layer it with some tape noise, which will add a bit of a vintage quality to the sound. We can do this by adding the one-shot selection instrument, also found in Eclectic Essentials. We'll add instrument track, select synths, scroll to Eclectic Essentials, and choose one-shot selection, which is the last instrument. After clicking the instrument, we see the piano roll, but let's record with the screen keyboard, like so. Here are some of the other one-shot sounds. And here's the tape noise. Let's record it in. These two sounds are going to form the introduction to our track. In this video, we'll use a classic song structure of introduction, this part, verse, pre-chorus, the build before a chorus, and a chorus. Don't worry if that sounds overwhelming, it will make sense to you as we get further into the video. We want to carry on the vibe of the introduction to the verse so a singer or a rapper can get into the groove of the track without the feel changing too quickly. For our verse, we will simply add a drum beat and a bass part to push the energy of the track. We want the verse to come in from bar 9 for 8 bars, so we'll select and loop bars 9 to 17 to build our groove around the loop that we've already imported and customized. So we'll press the loop icon, play the loop, and start by making our beat. We'll click on the Add Instrument icon and select Add Step Sequencer Track. We'll choose drums and percussion, then Drum Essentials, which is a free add-on pack in Endtrack Studio, and scroll down, choosing Electric's Roland TR-808. You won't stop using this drum preset once you hear it. We can hear sounds by clicking on their names. Kick 2 sounds great, but this pattern's currently too short, so we'll increase the number of steps from 8 to 16, which will give us a whole bar, and press Apply. Let's go for a half-time fill by adding a snare on the third beat, develop the kick drum pattern somewhat, layer the snare with a hand clap, and then we'll add hi-hats on beats 1, 2, 3, and 4. This groove is blending well with our loop, so it's time to add a touch of bass energy. We'll click the loop browser icon and put the instruments column in alphabetical order by clicking on the instruments column. This will group the types of instrument together. So we'll scroll down to find the synth bass group and select the first one, Assault on Precinct 13. Make sure that the follow song BPM button is enabled so we can preview these at our song tempo. We can hear the difference when it's not enabled. The bass sound is not matching our project tempo, so it sounds out of time. We'll re-enable the follow song BPM icon and audition some more of the bass synth sounds. Okay, I like Assault on Precinct 13. It's punchy and lifts the energy of what we have already. So we'll click and drag the loop below what we already have in our project on a new track. You can also see that this loop is 1 bar longer than our 8 bar loop selection. We can adjust this to fit perfectly by clicking and dragging the handle like so. Let's add the lead synth too. We'll go to Add Instrument Track, scroll to Synths, Eclectic Essentials, and we can see there are a bunch of synth instruments included with this pack. Let's go for Dream Synth. We'll also make sure to arm this new track for recording by pressing and selecting Arm Recording. We need to unarm our previous tape noise track because we don't need to record it now. This is a great sound for our melody, as the sound cuts over the top of what we have already composed. So let's write and record in a melody line. We'll start by finding the notes that can fit. This one works. These do too. Okay, the melody's taking shape. Let's try a take without recording. Okay, good. From the screen keyboard, we'll make sure one note legato is selected so that each note lasts until we press the next key. Actually, let's listen to that solo so you can hear the difference more clearly. Here's with one note legato, and here's without. I'm sure you can hear the difference. So we've re-enabled one note legato, deselected our loop in case any melody notes get played outside that range. Let's record in our melody. I didn't play that in completely in time. Let's get our MIDI melody exactly in time with the beat by quantizing it. To do this, we'll double-click on the MIDI region, we'll select our notes, and in one of the circles that appear, we'll long press. We'll see an option to quantize these notes, so let's press quantize. Pressing quantize will quantize the MIDI notes to the value selected in the grid, which can be adjusted like so. We're quantizing to 8, that is, 8th notes. Let's hear that section back. If we return to the start of the track, we can hear that the drum beat starts, but we actually only wanted the drum pattern to enter at the verse. To sort this, we'll open up the step sequencer and create a new pattern without any notes. If you're not familiar with the N-Track step sequencer, we'd highly recommend watching our step sequencer tutorial. The link is above now and also in the description below this video. We'll select playlist mode in the step sequencer and add a new pattern called pattern 2. We'll select this and go to the step sequencer view, and we can see that pattern 2 is completely blank. We'll return to playlist view and delete pattern 1, which was the verse beat playing through the intro, and add 8 bars of our silent pattern 2. Let's hear our intro now without the beat. We can see in the main project window that this removes our verse beat from the intro, which is what we wanted. But now if we listen to the transition into our verse at bar 9, we can hear that our verse beat is missing. To add our beat on the verse entry at bar 9, we'll add 16 bars of pattern 1, the first step sequencer pattern that we created. Let's hear the transition now from the intro into the verse. It's important to note that Eclectic Essentials is a premium sound bank. It's included when you subscribe to N-Track Studio Suite Edition on mobile or buy Suite Edition for Windows or Mac. The Suite Edition includes every sound pack available in N-Track. You also get access to all of our royalty-free samples and exclusive release-ready beats. More detail in the links above and in the description below this video. If you like this first part of building a full track in Android and want to see a part 2, which would cover going from the chorus to finalizing the track arrangement, do let us know in the comments. In the meantime, this full track is included in the project section of N-Track Studio's Suite Edition. It's called Eclectic Mood. It includes all parts, MIDI and effects so you guys can use it, release it, change it, or see some of the techniques used to help your own music making. Also, do let us know in the comments additional sample packs and instruments you'd love to see in N-Track. And don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Until the next time, have fun making music with N-Track. Cheers.